Okay.
We're back sooner than I thought we would be. These things, these horrible, horrible things. So if I put a roughing valve here, standard one-piece roughing valve is 10-inch spread. So that's going to put one of my valve bodies right dead center on that, on this guide, clamp, whatever you want to call it. If I was to do a three-piece valve, or which is a three-piece, yeah, because it's three-piece valve.
Yep, nailed it.
Anyways, those had a 12-inch spread, so that put my body right there. So either way, when you're within 6 to 8 inches of the overflow opening for these supports, clamps, whatever they're called, it creates a problem. So then I have to come in and I have to break it off without compromising the fiberglass, which I just use a chisel. And in fact, I'll show you how I break it off. And then I have to clean that to a flat edge to mount. Now with Moen valve, Moens use a ferrule and a plate. So then that way it can sit on uneven surfaces. But Delta, as we install here for Polish Homes, Deltas, you've got to have a nice, flat, even surface. Otherwise, it creates issues with the final trim being plumb. And so, even then, say I wanted to do a four-piece valve on this tub. I could with the design of this, and by four-piece, I mean one that has a pull-out sprayer. The issue then is you also, if you do this, you have your 6-inch spread. Then again, you still have another 6 inches over to another body. So just moving this over isn't going to cut it. You pretty much have to remove these from this area, because if the homeowner wants the sprayer to the right or to the left, because as we're looking at this, if I was to flip this up, this would be the hot, this would be the cold valve. This is all in the way. So these were to come in, but be within 12, you know, no, within 12 inches of either way, then I can install any valve on the market without having problems. Now to remove that, the trick I use is the way I do it. So that way, because you can just grab it with a pair of channel locks and rip it, but then sometimes the fiberglass comes with it, and that kind of defeats the purpose. So you take a nice moderate chisel that everybody should have for shimming toilets and cutting things, place it under the glue, and come at it. And just get it out of there. And beautiful. Nice, smooth, uncompromised surface. And all it takes is a little bit of manual manipulation. Anyways, so then we'll be back again for the thing I talked about the first time. Had I not seen this, I wouldn't have been back so soon, but now I'm back. I hope you missed me, but see you when we're setting the tub.